Hello friends, I'm Lokesh Mathur. I'm in front of you again with an interesting topic from aptitude segment and specifically from reasoning, that is clock. We definitely get some of the questions in every competitive exam from this topic. So let us today take first part of clock in which we'll be discussing some of the questions from this segment. Now, when we talk about this topic, we must be knowing how do we read time. So reading time is an important segment of this topic. Why I say it is important? Because whenever we get a question in the competitive exams, the time is represented in a certain fashion. For example, if I say the time is 5 minutes to 6, now most of the students face issue with reading this time. Or if I say it is 20 past 2. Again, many students do not understand what this time is talking about. So in the first slide or in the first segment of the video today, I'll be talking about reading of the time. Let us understand how do we read time. So for example, if I talk about an analog clock, for reading time, I divide this clock into 4 segments, or I can say 4 quarters. So this is my first quarter, this is my second quarter, the third one, and the fourth one. Now please understand, it all depends upon the minute hand, the needle which is used to read the minutes. The position of the minute hand decides whether we are reading the time in a certain way or not. So if the minute hand is in first or the second quadrant, we read the time in a different way. And if it is in the third or the fourth quadrant, time is read in a different way. Let me take an example. So for example, the time is 3:10. And we know that when it is 3:10, the minute hand certainly lies in the first quadrant. That means if it is in the first or the second quadrant, we read the time as minutes past hour. So like in this case, we can say it is 10 past 3 because the minute hand was in the first quadrant. Let me write one more example. It is 2:20. Now I know 20 is in the second quadrant. That means the minute hand would be in the second quadrant. So how do we write it? We write it as 20 past 2. A very simple, very basic concept, but we must know this before we attempt a question of clock. Now let's talk about something when the minute hand is in the third or the fourth quadrant. For example, if I say the time is 5:58, I know 5:58 means the minute hand is in the fourth quadrant. So how do we read it? We say that it is 2 minutes to the next hour, which is 6 o'clock. So 2 minutes left, because after adding 2 minutes to it, we will be getting the time, which is 6 o'clock. So we generally represent it as 2 minutes to 6. Let's take one more example. So if it is 4:49, so what do we say? Because the minute hand again is in the fourth quadrant, so we say it is 11 minutes to 5. That is the next hour. Also, there are a couple of situations here wherein minute hand can be at the quarter position or at the half position. So these two are the quarter positions. This is quarter one, and I can say even this is quarter two, and this one is half. Why I'm explaining this? Because let's say if the time is 4:30. So instead of saying 30 past 4, we generally say half past 4. Because the minute hand will be pointing at the half position. Likewise, if it is 7:45, instead of saying 15 minutes to 8, we say quarter to 8. One last example, suppose it is 9:15, So instead of saying 15 past 9, I would be saying quarter past 9. So this is how we read time when it comes to questions based on clock. Now, since we have the idea of reading the time, let's move to the actual concept of the topic clock from the reasoning segment. Now, when we talk about clock, we usually get few varieties of questions. For example, my first variety is when time is given and we have to calculate angle between the needles. We'll be taking it in detail in the same video. The second category is when angle is given and we have to calculate time. This is exactly reverse of the first category. Third one, when we have certain standard questions. Now, what do we mean by standard questions? I'll explain it to you when we'll be discussing the same set of questions in the next video. And the fourth and the most important thing, when we talk about faulty clocks. Faulty clocks. What do we mean by faulty clocks? The clocks which are not showing the correct time, or the clock which loses or gains time over the period. So these are the four major segments of questions that we get from clocks. Now, before we start with this, or before we talk about the time to angle concept, let us understand what are the basics we should be knowing before we approach a question. So when I talk about basics, we need to know that the entire circle of a clock is taken as a 360 degree angle. Because when we talk about questions based on angle, we should know this linear calculation. So the complete circle of the clock is a 360 degree circle. Also, we have three needles in a clock. One, hour. Second one is the minute needle. And the third and the thinnest is the needle talking about the seconds. Out of these three, majority of the questions come from hour and the minute situations, or the minute needles. So let's talk about these two needles and their speed with respect to time. So let me draw a simple table which will talk about these two needles and their speed. Now, when we talk about hour hand, first of all, we know that hour hand is the smaller needle, smaller and the thicker one. So this is the hour hand, for example. Now, the time taken by the hour hand to complete this one circle is 12 hours. That means in 12 hours, it completes the entire circle, which is nothing but 360 degree. Which means in 1 hour, it covers 30 degree. That's a simple linear calculation. And 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes. So 60 minutes and 30 degrees, which means in 1 minute, again, according to the linear calculation, it will cover 30 divided by 60 degree, and that is equal to half a degree. So every minute the hour hand covers half a degree. Similarly, let's do the calculation for the minute hand. To complete the circle, minute hand requires 1 hour. That is, in 1 hour, it completes 360 degree. Remember, when we'll approach a question in the competitive exams, we will not do this calculation again and again. So we should remember these concepts, because in the examinations, we will not spend much time in doing so. So 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes. And hence, in 60 minutes, it is 360 degree. So therefore, in 1 minute, minute hand covers 360 divided by 60, and which is equal to 6 degrees per minute. So we got to know the speeds of the hour hand, that is half a degree per minute, and the minute hand, 6 degrees per minute. Now, knowing these concepts, we'll be able to solve the questions going ahead in this video. Now let's start with the first question of the concept and Since this is the beginning, I'll be starting with easy questions and we'll go by the standard method. Then I'll explain you a couple of more methods which can work or which can be used even without pen and paper. So let's take the first question from the topic. Now the question says, find out the angle between the minute and the hour hand when the time is, let's say, 20 past 2. Now I told you in the beginning, the time will be represented in this format. So 20 past 2. Now we need to figure out that this is 2:20. Because unless we know what is the time, we'll not be able to calculate the angle. Now let me draw a clock. May not be circular, but still a random clock which has 12 major divisions. We all know that. So I'm just giving a rough spot for those divisions. And now let me put these needles in the right way. So if it is 2:20, my minute hand will certainly point at 4, number 4, and our hand will be somewhere here. So the question is talking about what is the angle between the needles when it is 2:20. So let me explain you it in detail. Whenever we calculate angle or whenever we even draw angle on our papers, on the notebooks that we use a reference horizontal line. So even here, I would suggest you to use a horizontal line and that is nothing but 12 o'clock. Why? Because at 12, both the needles are coinciding with each other. So what has happened? From 12 to 2:20, minute hand has traveled this much of the distance. That is the bigger angle. And the hour hand has traveled the smaller angle. So if I get to know the bigger angle and the smaller angle, then bigger angle minus smaller angle will give me my angle when the time is 2:20. So let's see how we can do this. So first of all, if I have to calculate the bigger angle, and I know that minute hand travels 6 degrees per minute. That is, now in 20 minutes, minute hand will travel 20 multiplied by 6, that is 120 degree, which is nothing but equal to the bigger angle. Similarly, when we talk about the hour hand, every hour it covers 30 degree. That means in 2 hours, it covers 60 degree, which is quite easy. Every hour 30 degree, 2 hours 60 degree. But remember, the hour hand is not at 2. Let me explain you this thing in detail. Let's suppose this is where the 2 is. But because the time is 2:20, and if you visualize at 2:20, the hour hand does not remain at 2. It obviously drifts further towards 3. So therefore, it is not going to be 60 degree. The smaller angle will not be only 60. The minute hand has traveled only for 120 degree, but then the hour hand has traveled for some more time. And what is that some more time? That is 20 minutes. And every minute the hour hand travels half a degree. This linear calculation we have done already. So now 20 multiplied by half gives me 10 degrees, which means the smaller angle is 60 plus 10 and that is equal to 70 degree. So this is my smaller angle and therefore the angle between the needles, that is equal to bigger angle minus smaller, will be 120 minus 70 and the answer remains 50 degrees. Please understand, for the same question in the options you will also get 60 degrees. But remember, my answer cannot be 60 because there is a drift by the hour hand as well. So these are the three steps we'll be talking about when we solve a question. First step, the minute hand travel. Second step, the hour hand travel to the closest hour. And the third step, the drift of the hour hand. and then there is a subtraction and addition to get the final answer. So this is one question wherein we calculated angle based on the time given. Let me take one more example for better clarification. So this time, again, we are calculating angle on the basis of time. And what is the time this time? Let's talk about it is 2 minutes to 6. Now again, by reading this, we should be knowing what is the time. So 2 minutes to 6 means we are talking about 5:58. Now please pay attention because I'll be explaining multiple methods to solve this question. Obviously, we will go by the conventional method discussed earlier, first of all, and then I'll tell you the short tricks or probably some more methods. Now let's assume again this is my clock. Please, you have to assume that it's a circle. So there are 12 divisions. And now we are talking about a time which is 5:58. So 58, so minute hand would be somewhere here. And hour hand would be a little before 6. So this is the angle we have to calculate. Now I told you in the previous question, we have to assume something as the reference and that reference should be 12 o'clock. So both my needles coincide at 12 o'clock. So what has happened now? My minute hand has traveled for 58 minutes. That's my step number one. For 58 minutes, my minute hand has traveled with 6 degrees per minute. And therefore, it comes out to be 348 degrees. So my bigger angle is 348 degrees. Now let's talk about the second step. I told you, 5 hours, that is the closest hour, multiply by 30 degree every hour and therefore I get 150 degrees. But this is not complete. I need to check here, my hour hand is not at 5. It has drifted further because it's not 5 o'clock, it's 5:40, in fact 5:58. So for 58 minutes, my hour hand drifts with half a degree every minute. And therefore, it comes out to 29 degrees in total. So my smaller angle becomes 179 degrees. And therefore, what is my answer? It becomes 348 minus 179. And therefore, my value becomes 169 degrees as the answer. So this is the method that we discussed in the previous question as well. Now let's see if we can approach this question in a different way. So probably if I say that this is method number one, I'll be talking about method number two now. Please pay attention. Now we know that the time is 5:58 and after 2 minutes, the needles will be in a straight line. That is at 6 o'clock, at 6, my angle will be 180 degrees. So instead of calculating for 58 minutes, what if I do the calculation for 2 minutes? Certainly I'll get the answer a lot quicker. Let's see how that can be done. So 2 minutes ago, this minute hand would be somewhere here. And when I say somewhere here, since the minute hand travels 6 degrees per minute, 2 minutes ago, it would be 12 degrees behind. And therefore, I can say it becomes 180 minus 12. But please remember, 2 minutes ago, even my hour hand would be somewhere towards 5. And what is that somewhere? Because hour hand travels half a degree per minute. So 2 minutes ago, it must be 1 degree towards 5. And hence will increase my angle. You can do this visualization and directly you will get the value as 169 degrees as the answer. Now in many cases, your time which is given to you will be close to 12, 6, 3 and 9. Because these are the standard angles that we know. And therefore, this can be easily done in this method. There is one more method of solving the question, and let us look at that method very quickly, because this method will help us throughout to get the answers. Let's approach third method and the most useful method. Let's understand it. Suppose the time is 12 o'clock. Suppose the time is 12 o'clock. And at 12, since the needles coincide, the angle between them is 0 degrees. Now let's suppose the time is 12:01. That means instead of coinciding, the minute hand will travel for 6 degrees and the hour hand will travel for half a degree, obviously towards 1. That means my effective angle will be now 5.5 degrees. Now let's talk about the third case. Let me take, instead of 12, it is 12:02. That means my minute hand will travel for 2 minutes, and that is 12 degrees. My hour hand will travel for 2 minutes, that is 1 degree, and therefore now the effective angle between them is 11 degrees. So if you observe this carefully, every minute we are increasing with 5.5 degree. So I can say so that 5.5 degree per minute is my relative speed. That means both the needles are either getting separated or moving towards each other with the speed of 5.5 degree per minute. Now this concept will be highly beneficial in the entire topic of clocks. But for this particular question, let's see how this is useful. So when we say it is 5:58, after 2 minutes, it will be 6 o'clock. So we are talking about 2 minutes ago. 2 minutes ago. So at 6 o'clock, the angle is 180 degree. That means 2 minutes ago, as we saw, it is 5.5 degree per minute. So 2 minutes ago, it would be 11 degrees less, because 5.5 for 1 minute and therefore 11 degrees for 2 minutes. And thus my answer directly becomes 169. This is such a useful phenomena to calculate the questions based on clock. We will be using this method for most of the questions that we do. In some of the books, you will also find one last method, and that is a formula based on it. I usually do not suggest my students this, but still, since it is available in the book, there is a formula which says angle is equal to 30 times of h minus 11 by 2 times of m. And this is the direct formula they use to calculate the angle, where h stands for hour, m stands for minute. So whatever time is given, if you put those values in the formula, you will get the angle directly. But I would recommend the most important method would be this third one. That is the relative speed, 5.5 degree per minute. We will see in the coming videos how this method is so useful for us. I hope you have understood the basic concept of clock so far. In the coming videos, we'll take it to the next level. I wish you would be liking the videos. For more such videos, you can subscribe to our channel, that is Swanith Education, and click on the bell icon so that you can get notifications for the upcoming videos. Thank you.